Grab your cereal.
Life.
Yeah, life cereal.
Life cereal.
Yeah.
Mikey likes it.
Yeah.
He likes it. If you're looking for a daily Bible study, you found the right place. Today, what's our scripture?
Romans chapter 15 and verse 4. And we're going to be talking about where our hope is going to be birthed in your soul. Sometimes we need a little hope because we're in hopelessness. So we're going to get some hope in you today. You're going to love
wow.
it.
Wow. Yeah. And it's TikTok Tuesday. We'll be right back. Good morning, welcome to Wake Up.
Where we wake up.
I'm Pastor Scott.
Pastor Jason.
What a great show for him today.
Yeah, we really do.
I'll pray over your day. We got a scripture for your day. We're going to have a whole lot of fun today. Mm-hmm. We got TikToks. If you're a new subscriber, make sure.
You type in where you're from. We like to read that on Wednesdays. And don't forget, October 20th, we're going to be out at Bellbank Park. We'll put something down here, but we're just going to be worshiping
the
Lord under the stars. We're doing revival. Bring your family. Bethel Music with Josh Baldwin's going to be there. Real Talk.
Really?
It's going to be incredible. It's free, too. It's incredible.
Which is not a bad deal.
Yeah,
anyway,
this is a great scripture. Romans 15 and verse 4. It says this, for whatever was written in earlier times was written for our instruction.
Wait. So it wasn't written to make life bad. To take
no,
away.
Because
a lot of people think that it's like to make life less fun. You ever do that with your kids? You give them something to do and they're like, oh, you ruined my day. Like a 5-year-old taking a nap. Don't you wish, let me tell you what I wish. I wish that once a day somebody would come to you and me today, like at 11.
Yeah.
And after we had a nice full meal, said, hey, you have to go take a nap. Would that be a great day?
That would be not a bad day. I would love that day.
Right? But the kids hate it.
Yeah.
It's like the worst thing in the world.
Yeah.
Why are you trying to ruin all the fun?
Right. No, I don't want to take a nap. They cry.
You're right.
I would never cry if my wife was like, okay, honey, it's nap time. I'd be like, okay. I don't get nap time. I get chores time.
Yeah, we get chores time.
We need to go pick up some new plants for the backyard. So that's what we've been doing lately.
Have you?
Yeah, because it's the fall now in Arizona, so you can actually plant things and they won't catch fire. They'll actually grow.
Yeah, yeah.
So we lost about 13 plants over the summer.
Yeah,
because
I lose all my flowers
scorch.
Are all gone.
Yeah.
It's just barren wasteland.
So we're replacing all the plants and doing that. So anyways, but here it says that it was the stuff that was written in earlier times, the Old Testament, right? The early stuff, the prophets, the stories, all the things we get out of there. You know, that's not wasted space.
No.
There's Jesus and life and new covenant all over the place. All kinds of metaphors and learning things that we can learn from, experiences that we can see, stories of how God interacted with men and how people of faith overcame, and the witnesses that we have of people who held onto their faith despite all the reasons they should have let it go. You know, that stuff's there for us to instruct us. And it says this, so that through perseverance and the encouragement of the scriptures, we might have hope.
What? We might have hope.
So hope is going to be birthed when you take instruction from scripture and you persevere with it.
Come on.
But it says it has the word encouragement in there because it's trying to show you that God's word is there to make you encourage you,
to build you up, to give you faith. Cometh by hearing, and hearing the word of God.
Yeah,
right? Faith is the substance of things hoped for. So you see how it all ties together. That the scripture is there to give me hope. The hope is what encourages, what builds up my faith. My faith is what brings to me the great things that I need to have in my life.
Yeah.
It's all how God ties it together. The Word of God isn't meant to give you a bunch of things that you can't have and can't do.
Yes.
The Word of God is about giving you things that you can have and can do.
I think that's why it says the encouragement is like,
come on.
Is the scripture should always build you up when you read
yes.
it. It
it's
always,
the good news.
It's the good news. It's good things are about to happen. Your life's about to get better. Look at the God who loves you and gave everything up for you. Look at the God who made you a joint heir with his son, Christ Jesus.
Yes.
Look at the God who gave you his spirit on the inside of you and made you the temple of the Lord. He made you the Ark of the Covenant. Look at the God who assigned angel armies to you to help defend
you in
time
of
need. Look at the God who told you where the storehouse is, who plants you deep in his house that you might flourish, right? So
you've built me up. I want to go run.
This is what he's saying. This is what it's supposed to do in your life. It's supposed to give you perseverance and encouragement. And from that place, you're going to have birth in your soul that we might have hope.
It's not meant to condemn. It's not meant to make
well,
you
this
feel
is
bad.
The thing. If it's taking away your hope.
It's not meant to tear you down. But, you know, when you get the Word of God, it should build you up.
Yes.
And encourage you. Yeah, I made mistakes, but my God doesn't remember my wrongdoings, right? His grace is sufficient for me. As Paul said it, I keep doing those things I don't want to do. He says, but there is now no condemnation for those that are in Christ. And so, once again, even Paul saying, hey, I do things I don't want to do, but God's word is what builds me up and encourages me so that I can live life at a higher plane, right?
Right.
That I can do things a little bit better. I get it. I made a mistake yesterday, but I'm going to do things a little bit better today because I've been encouraged and built up by the word of God.
Boy, that's powerful. Can you pray over the day?
No, we're going to TikTok.
Oh, TikTok Tuesday.
TikTok Tuesday. We do these. What do? The TikToks? These are, we do these for you. We kind of weed out all the garbage and we bring out some of the best TikToks. So this is their favorite thing they love.
This is your favorite fun. I hope you stick around for it. Yeah. Here we go. Let's play some TikToks.
This is my favorite one. You ever do that? You're trying to learn a dance? No, I loved him. That's for you. I bought that one for you. I knew Jason would like that one.
That was my brother, though, on the lips.
You okay? Oh! I mean, to be completely fair, that second one was in self-defense because she was going to kill him.
Your husband has superpowers.
Chris. I think I saw a spider, but I don't know where it went.
Oh my God.
I do.
Is this still good?
Yes.
Is this still good?
No.
Is this still good?
Toss it.
Is this still good?
Too old.
That's so true. My wife always asks me if it's still good.
Chuck it. That has mold.
What is this?
Still good.
That's so true.
Hey, Chris?
Yeah? This is what... These are the simple things your wife wants. These are the simple things. That's all she wants.
She just wants that.
Yep.
This is anyway. You want to pray over the day?
Yeah. Well, if you receive something from today's message, it really meant something to you. I just encourage you to be generous. Sow some seed towards that word that you
partner
heard.
Partner with us.
Yep. And help us reach more people.
And when you partner with us, I mean that's what it is. We together we're touching the world. Mm-hmm. And so if you can do $5, $10, $20, whatever God puts on your heart. We encourage you to be, just be a giver. Mm-hmm. Amen?
Amen.
Dear Father, Lord, we ask that you richly bless them. Lord, that we take the hope from your word of God, Lord, and we allow it to encourage us and build us up, Lord, that we may make some mistakes, Lord, that we know that through Christ we can do all things, and that you with us, it doesn't matter what's against us, Lord, that the enemy may show up in one way, but they'll flee in seven. We thank you and praise you, Lord, for the hope that you have, the encouragement you have, and for a blessed day that is in front of us. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Well, watch this clip.
You know, for many people as they go through life, a little fire in life, and things just seem to pop, and things seem to go bad. But you know, if you have just a little bit of water inside, just a little bit of the word, right? You got an hour on a Sunday, you got just a little bit of word in you. It doesn't matter the fire and what's going on. Devil, doesn't matter what you try to do. It doesn't harm me. It doesn't harm my house. Nothing can do. Come on, somebody. That when I got some of God's word inside of me, there isn't a fire. There isn't a problem. There isn't a circumstance that could possibly take me down. Come on, somebody. I'm a palm tree. Say it. I am a palm tree. Storm, bring your best. Wind, bring your best. Come on, somebody. Try to knock me down. I just get back up because the righteous may fall seven times, but we will arise. Come on, somebody. Some of you out there are listening today. You will arise. You're going through a breakup, but you will arise. You're going through a financial trouble, but you will arise. You lost your job, but you will arise. And when I come back, devil, guess what? I come back stronger. I come back better. I come back bigger. I'm able to handle more and do more. Come on, church. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, be in church this weekend, wherever your church is at, and have an epic day.